Good morning, and these are your news updates for today. In Mexico, searchers recovered 28 charred bodies from several mass graves in southern Mexico by late Sunday amid fears the remains belonged to some of the 43 missing college students last seen in police custody on September 26. In a news conference Sunday evening, Guerrero State Prosecutor Blanco confirmed the toll as accused leaders of the Guerrero Undos gang of ordering Iguala Municipal Police to disappear and finish off the students. He said investigators were still searching for a motive, but that 29 people had been arrested and sent to jail, pending formal charges, most of them current or former members of the Iguala Police Force. A state just has formally charged 22 Iguala police officers with murder in relation to the deaths of the six people on September 26th and 27th, Mr. Blanco said. Guerrero's Undos is one of the several criminal bands who bloody feuding has claimed hundreds of lives in Guerrero and adjoining states in recent years. Authorities were waiting results of DNA testing to determine the bodies were those of the missing youths. Mr. Blanco said the process will be aided by Mexico federal authorities and foreign forensics experts would take between 15 days and 2 months, he said. Five Indian civilians were killed, at least 25 wounded on Monday in fighting along a stretch of the disputed border with Pakistan in the disputed Kashmir region, the heaviest toll since India called off a round of peace talks last month. The Himalayan region of Kashmir has been a bone of contention between India and Pakistan since they became independent in 1947. They have fought 3 years and came close to a fourth in 2001, and there has been regular clashes along the de facto border known as the line of control in the area. Pakistani forces shelled the village of Arnia about 3 kilometers from the border in the early hours of Monday, killing and wounding the civilians, according to Rakesh Kumar, an Inspector General of the Indian Border Security Forces. The attack coincided with the Eid al-Adha festival celebrated by Muslims in both countries. Pakistan's army did not immediately respond to requests for comment. Another Indian officer, Lieutenant Colonel Brijesh Pandey, said the army shot dead 3 Pakistani-based militants trying to cross into India further along the heavily militarized LOC. 2 militants escaped back to Pakistan, he said. Muslim separatists have been fighting Indian forces in India's part of Kashmir since 1989. Pakistan rejects India's accusation that it trains and arms rebels in parts of Kashmir it controls and sends them into the Indian side. The latest round of mortar and gunfire began on Friday when Pakistan's army said it responded to unprovoked firing from the Indian side. In Turkey, the Turkish forces Monday used tear gas to push dozens of reporters and Kurdish civilians away from the border zone close to intense fighting for the besieged Syrian town of Kobani. The armed forces employed tear gas for the second day in a row to push people from the border area, which has become increasingly dangerous owing to the mortar fired from Syria, the AFP correspondent reported. Leave or else we will intervene, the security forces ordered through loudspeakers on trucks. Reporters as well as local Kurds were anxiously watching the fight for Kobani between Kurdish fighters and ISIS militants now have been pushed back to some 700 meters from the border. The security forces had already on Sunday afternoon ordered them away from the immediate vicinity of the borders areas toward the town of Surik after a mortar wounded 5 people on the Turkish territory. And those are your news updates for October 6, 2014. You guys have a great Monday. Good morning, and these are your news updates for today. In Mexico, searchers recovered 28 charred bodies from several mass graves in southern Mexico by late Sunday amid fears the remains belonged to some of the 43 missing college students last seen in police custody on September 26. In a news conference Sunday evening, Guerrero State Prosecutor Blanco confirmed the toll as accused leaders of the Guerrero Undos gang of ordering Iguala Municipal Police to disappear and finish off the students. He said investigators were still searching for a motive, but that 29 people had been arrested and sent to jail, pending formal charges, most of them current or former members of the Iguala Police Force. A state just has formally charged 22 Iguala police officers with murder in relation to the deaths of the six people on September 26th and 27th, Mr. Blanco said. Guerreros Unidos is one of the several criminal bands who